If you're experiencing heating issues with your liquid-cooled motorcycle and you're looking for a solution, this series should help you out. In these videos, we'll be talking about enhancing, replacing, and maintaining some parts of your motorcycle to make sure that it manages heat efficiently. I'm Augie F. Welcome to the channel. Before we get into things, here's a quick shout out to Grand Pitstop for sending me this G-Roller. I've used it to lube the chain on my KTM and have also used it to clean the wheels, both front and back, on the RC390. If you're interested in getting one, there's a link in the description of this video and a discount code included too. Alright, let's get straight into it. Firstly, let's understand the different components that we can impact, which will then have an effect on the engine cooling system. You have the radiator fan, the coolant, and finally the engine oil. Now, while I will be talking about the changes I've made specifically to my KTM RC390, understand that these changes can be applied, or these techniques can be applied, to pretty much all of the liquid-cooled motorcycles that are sold in India. If you're from another country, I'd advise you check your user manual before you go and fill coolant in your air-cooled motorcycle. That won't end well. Also, you may not need all of the steps that I'll be sharing in the series to help you out. Sometimes just the first two steps should help you make your engine run cooler. So what I'd advise you to do is after each step, make sure that you test your motorcycle out and see how much of an impact it's made to the engine cooling system. Now in this video, we'll be focusing primarily on the radiator, but let's firstly understand how the radiator works. Coolant is circulated through channels in the motor and absorbs the heat generated by the engine. The heated coolant is then pumped through a radiator, which cools it down using air, and it flows additional air through the radiator using the radiator fan. The cool down fluid is then circulated back through the engine and the cycle continues. Now, let's get working on the motorcycle. Our first plan of action is to make sure that there's enough air flowing through the radiator. If the fins are clogged or they're bent out of shape, that reduces the amount of air flowing through the radiator, and in turn, it affects the radiator's ability to cool down the coolant which is flowing through it. What you need is some water, a soft toothbrush, and mild detergent. Spray or gently pour some water on the radiator. Avoid using too much force or using something like a jet spray, because that kind of water hitting the radiator could bend the fins further out of shape. If your motorcycle has a radiator shroud like the RC390 does, remove it during this step because it will make this job a lot easier and it will give you direct access to the radiator. Use a toothbrush and mild detergent to get the dirt out of the radiator fins and then wash the radiator again. Owing to its position, the radiator is one of the parts of the motorcycle which gathers the most dirt and is often overlooked when cleaning. So chances are this is probably the first time you're specifically being asked to clean your radiator. After you're done cleaning the radiator, observe the fins to see if there's any noticeable damage. If they are bent out of shape, this will reduce the amount of air that flows through the radiator. But don't worry, they're relatively easy to bend back into shape. And for this job, I use my trusty nail file. It's narrow enough to get into the gaps, and also wide enough to create the exact gap the fins originally had. Take your time to reshape the radiator fins, and when you're done with that, reinstall the radiator shroud. Now ride your motorcycle for a day or two and observe if there's any significant difference in the way it manages heat. If there is, you're sorted. For me, for my motorcycle, I noticed a slight difference in the way it managed heat. It was a lot better, of course, but if I had to put a number to it, it would be about 10% of the overall change that I noticed once I made all of these changes to my motorcycle, which I'll be sharing with you in a bit. The next change I made to the radiator was to the radiator shroud. Now, when I was installing and removing the radiator shroud, I noticed that there was very little damage done to the shroud, and I questioned the amount of air that was actually flowing through that shroud because of the way it was designed. I decided to replace this shroud with an aluminium radiator guard after reading the improvement other 390 owners experienced in KTM forums. Now, while there might be several other radiator guards which you can buy for your motorcycle, if you're interested in having a look at the specific one that I'm using for Rage, you can click on the link in the description of this video, which will take you to my Amazon page. Now, this has links to not just the radiator guard which I'm talking about, but a list of a whole lot of other products that I use on Rage and a bunch of safety gear as well, which I've got back there. Again, no one's forcing you to buy, that decision is completely yours. Please don't get triggered in the comment section. I'm just trying to help you guys out. Installation of the radiator guard was easy. All I needed to do was take out 4 bolts and 6 push fasteners to undo the radiator shroud. After this, I used the same 4 bolts to install the radiator guard. After installing the radiator guard, I rode the motorcycle around for a few days and noticed that the overheating issues which I was experiencing earlier started to reduce. Again, if I had to put a number to it, I'd say this would have accounted for about 20% of the overall improvement. With these few changes, there was more air flowing through the radiator guard, and the amount of time required to cool the engine down was reducing. But there's more that could be done, and in the next video from the series, we'll be focusing on the liquids that help manage the heat of the engine. I hope you guys found this video interesting and the information useful. If you did, please give the video a thumbs up, it helps the channel. If you've not subscribed already, please hit that subscribe button and the bell icon as well to stay notified. As always, at least wear your helmets while riding your motorcycles, and ride safe. It's a freaking jungle out there. Goodbye. Parcel the great bag came up, you can't hate that. Self-made, you can't take that. Yeah, self-made, you can't make that. Some said I need a record deal, I need a co-sign, I need a Dre track. But all the time I had a mean flow, I had a cold grind, and that's a great match. Payback codes and I make racks. In my pockets gon' stay fat, cause I murk beats and I slay.